Hello everyone, we've finished freertos tutorial series, then I would like to explain another useful ESP-IDF library. Debugging is a very significant topic for embedded software engineering. We have used printf function up to now. On this video, I'll explain function of ESP logging library. Let's start the machine. ESP-IDF have a logging library which have so convenient functions. On the complex projects, debugging the console with printf function could be hard to detect an error or a situation because it doesn't have any coloring. With ESP logging library, we can use three coloring and we can assign a tag. Let's start the logging example. I'm starting from task example that I have published. There are two created tasks on this example. Firstly, let's add ESP log library. Then I'll define two tag to use on logging functions. After that, let's check inside of task 1. As we remember, there is a printf function that writes hello from task 1 to the console. I'll change it with logging function. ESP log I is used to write a string to console with green color. I means info. The difference of using printf and logging functions are tags. Printf function is used with one parameter if it doesn't have any variable like this example, but logging function is used with an additional parameter which is tag. I'll write task 1 tag as I defined before. We can also write it with quotation mark like that. But defining has simplicity on complex project. Additionally, let's jump to task 2. There's a printf function that writes hello from task 2 to console. I'll change it with logging function. But let's use different color for it. I'm writing ESP log W for task 2. W comes from warning. And it uses yellow as color. Let's add task 2 tag for the first parameter. Then we can check the monitor after flashing. As we can see, the functions are using colorization. With this feature, we can easily see what the processor doing, especially when we use the console extensively. This is our message. This is our tag. And also there is a number. This is one of the important features of logging library. As you may remember, I've used xtask getTickCount function to see how many time is passed from the beginning. This library always print the time, so we don't need to add tick count to whole print functions. After that, let's use error log function with interrupt. I'll copy interrupt initialization part from the my interrupt example. Then let's write ESP log E function. I'll write its tag with quotation mark because I'll use it only once. So there's no need to define it. Also, I would like to show another function of ESP log. On many projects, we will store the data with hex value. Let's create an hex array and write some data. Then ESP log buffer hex function has three parameters. First parameter is tag. Second is array name. Last parameter is how much character will be written. Let's write 20 characters of buffer array. And lastly, I would like to show you how can we get time value which is written on log. Let's write printf function and let's write ESP log timestamp. Also, let's write xtask get tick count. Then, let's see the results. As you can see, ESP log timestamp function get the value which is written on ESP log, and tick count function get milliseconds divided by 10. And the difference between these, tick count starts from when the task are started, I mean there. Timestamp starts from beginning of the waking up the ESP32. As you can see on the console, there are some process before task starting. Lastly, let's check interrupt response. I press the button, then we see a message with red color because I've choose ESP log error function. So this is how we use logging library. On the complex projects, this method looks more professional and more readable. That's all I am going to talk about today. Stay motivated and subscribe me. Let's control the controllers together.